Hey guys, I've got some bad news regarding me and the channel and whatnot. It's really mostly to do with my computer. But I made a post on my Facebook page a while ago, if anyone saw that. But I said I'd most likely be quitting YouTube and just focusing on Twitch. I like spending most of my time when I want to broadcast my games, I'll just stream it on Twitch instead of recording. And I don't know, it all depends really. Here's what happened. I got a new power supply and hooked it up to my computer, and it immediately killed my hard drives and damaged some other components. I mean, not immediately. I was able to start it up once, but then it shut off, and I noticed after that that my hard drives weren't detected at all, not even in my BIOS. So turns out they got killed, they got fried due to over voltage, and it might just be a little PCB damage. I haven't tried to fix it yet, but I'm gonna get to that ASAP after I do a little bit more research on what my options are. There are possible solutions, but you know, they require me to spend money. And yeah, I don't know, we'll see. So it really all depends on how that goes. I'm gonna try the freezer trick with the hard drives eventually. Hopefully that doesn't make it worse. But yeah, the company that sold me the hard drive, I mean, I bought it from Newegg, they can't do anything. The manufacturers are really the ones at fault, EVGA, and they won't do anything for me either, because they say since I technically can't prove that it was their power supply that damaged my system, they won't do anything. So kinda screwed. Unless I wanna sue them, which I mean, that would end up costing me about as much as actually that wouldn't cost me as much as data recovery software or service, but it would cost me about as much as getting new hardware. I don't know. But yeah, I mean, what was on the hard drives, it was all important information, you know, like 4.5 terabytes of important data, all lost. You know, one of the drives was a 2 terabyte drive, and it was full of nothing but, you know, gameplay footage that I had planned to upload and never got to. You know, a lot of it was like C9 and other games. But you know, that's all lost. So I mean, when that happened, I kind of lost motivation for even putting effort into making videos like I used to. So I'm just not gonna, I don't know. If I can't get it back, I'm probably not gonna bother anymore. I'd probably just use YouTube the way I first used to when I first started, you know. I just made videos whenever I wanted to save something, you know, like kind of like taking a picture. It's just memories, you know, just to look back at gaming moments. It's really all I used it for in the first place. So, yeah. But Twitch is still gonna be a thing for me. It's on hold right now since I don't currently have two monitors working. I only have one because my graphics card that got damaged by the power supply. So, yeah, that's on hold until I can get all that sorted out. In that case, it's simple. I just gotta get the power supply RMA'd and get my graphics card replaced, and I'm good. As far as what games I'm gonna stream, I'm not sure. But the main games right now that I play are Blade and Soul, CS:GO, Ultra Street Fighter 4, and I'll probably get back into Black Desert. I don't think I'll play on the Korean server any like right now. I'll probably just get on the North American one when it comes out. Probably gonna play Blader and Ninja, because those are the classes I played on Korea. But yeah, as far as C9 goes, I don't know. I mean, that game's. I shouldn't even need to say this, but the game's dead, and I haven't been on it in a while. If I do ever get on it, it's just to do a couple matches and then log off and whatnot, you know. So, doubt I'll be streaming that very much, but if I do, I'll let you know. Yeah, I guess that's pretty much all I had to say. For those of you who followed me on Facebook, I have like 136 likes on Facebook, something like that. So there's a good chunk of people who actually like look at the stuff I post on there every now and then. So if you wanna be up to date on what's going on with me when I stream, the first place I'll paste my link is on my Facebook page. So you know, you could like me on there. Yeah, that's pretty much all I had to say. Other than that, just to try and enjoy these matches, you know. They were fun as fuck, actually. I enjoyed these matches. It was nothing but mind games. Like, all we were doing was, like... how do I put it? After evasive dash, our strongest move is round swing into shining cutter, what I just did, right? And... We were basically coming up with counters for that on the fly in these matches, and it came down to mind games. Who would get the grab right there? Who would be able to evasive into a grab or get the block on shining and punish? You know, because after round swing into shining cutter, you don't have break cancel, which is the skill necessary to cancel shining cutter, and that means that shining cutter is completely punishable after it. So if you whiff, you get punished. And we were just like bringing out the mind games in these matches. It was super fun. But anyway, I'll just shut up now. You guys enjoy the fights. Thanks for listening to me, and peace.
Round